Emeril Lagasse, and welcome to the essence of Emeril. You know, today I'm going to dedicate the whole show to some starters. Some starters on the menu, some starters that should be on your menu, and particularly a couple of my favorites in New Orleans. But you got to really choose the starters and sort of balance the whole meal around the beginning, because that's what a starter is. And first, what we're going to do is make a favorite of mine, some corn cakes. That's right, some corn cakes. What I've got is a little Granny Smith apple that I've peeled, and I've just sort of chopped it up real fine. Then I have a little bit of fresh corn that I just sort of blanched a little bit in a little salted water, and then I've taken that corn right off the cob. Okay, just like that. So we have some fresh corn. And then, now what we're going to do is we're going to start with an egg. And we're going to whisk it a little bit. I have a little bit of milk. Now, I've got a little bit of a little baking powder, which is going to make it poof up. Got to have those cakes poofy. And then I have a little masa flour, little regular flour. And look at this array of spices that I have. I have a little cumin, some chili powder, some of that great Emeril essence, a little cayenne to just give it a little kick. And I also have a little turmeric. A little turmeric, which is going to give it some great, great color. And I'm going to add all of those spices in there. And then, we're going to whisk. Oh, you should smell this already. Woo! See the color? That's from the turmeric. Doesn't that look great? Now, here's the great part right here, is once you get it all mixed up, we're going to take some of that Granny Smith apple, and we're going to take some of that fresh corn. Oh, boy. And then what we're going to do is we're going to just sort of, with a spatula, we're going to fold those ingredients into our batter. Nice and chunky. Then, what we're going to do, we're going to take a little spoon. I've got this griddle of ours here. Hey, you better believe it, griddle. We got the latest here at the Television Food Network. Look at this. It's got a good heat on it right now. You can do it in a little nonstick pan as well. But watch this. We're going to take these, and we're going to make these little cakes. We'll take these little cakes. They're like little flapjacks. I'm going to make these little cakes here. Make sure we get a little oil. And then we're going to let these griddle up a little bit. We're going to keep an eye on these so that way, flip them over. And we'll just sort of keep an eye on those little guys right there. You know, you don't have to have a griddle. You can just do this, like I said, in a little non-stick pan will work too. You want to make sure that it's not too hot, because you want really the inside also to be able to cook. You see how it's kind of a little soft right there? It's not cooked enough. We're going to flip them back over. Oh, yeah. Now, once they get cooked in the center, What we're going to do is we're going to take these little guys off. I'm just going to put them right here for right now. Look at that. I feel like I'm cooking breakfast. But then I'm going to show you what we're going to do with these guys. You see this stuff right here? Choupique. 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 That's caviar in Louisiana. That's Louisiana caviar. It's from a fish called choupique, which is one of the true caviar roe producing fishes. And what we do, one of these great starters, I got a little chive cream in my little squirt bottle here. And then we're going to take one of these cakes, set it on the bottom, little chive cream. And then we're going to take a little soup gone of caviar. You see that? And then we're going to make a little milfoy. What do you think? Like a little sandwich. We'll add a little bit more of this chive cream and a little bit more of the caviar. Hey, we'll throw a few chives in there too. And then we'll make a milfoy, little layers. And then we get a little chive cream again. And then we'll garnish it with a little bit more of caviar and a little bit more chives. Hey, we'll give it a little festivity. And then I didn't forget about this cake. We'll just take this cake and cut it in little pieces. It's got the apple. You see that? It's got the apple, and we'll just add a little bit of that right there. And, hey, that works for me. That's a great starter for me. How about for you? I'll tell you what, after the break, I'm going to show you another delicious shrimp, succulent shrimp. Stay with me. We'll be right back. Well, welcome back. This next starter also is one that just flies right out of the restaurant's kitchen. We take these large shrimp, we cook them in some andouille sausage. Well, actually what we do is we make this little andouille sausage crust. But I'm going to show you a simplified version of this. First thing we want to do is we're going to get a little bit of oil, a little olive oil, and we're just going to just coat the bottom of this little gratin dish and the sides. And then we want to make sure that the shrimp, that we've deveined them. We'll take out the devein. And then what I do is you can either layer them like this, or you can actually open them up and stuff them. Really depends on what you'd like. Well, we just sort of layer them like this. You see that? Sort of side-by-side succulent shrimp. We'll just layer them open like that. Now, you could do this with other shellfish like scallops. There we go. So we got them all opened up. Now, what we want to do is we want to season the shrimp. That way they taste good. Now, what I like to do is I like to take some chopped up andouille. If you can't find andouille, you can use charisse. You could use, you know, any kind of sausage. But you see how lean that sausage is? You see how lean this is? There's not a lot of fat. It's very, very, very lean. And I also want to take a little bit of breadcrumb. Little grated Parmesan cheese. And sort of mix that together. Add a little bit more breadcrumb. You see that? Now what we're going to do is we're going to take and add a little moisture into it. We're going to just take a little bit of olive oil. And we're going to give that a little bit more seasoning. And then what we're going to do is we're going to work some of the moisture in the breadcrumb from the olive oil, as well as we want to allow this andouille is going to, it's just going to give off a little bit of juice and a little natural fat. So we want to take that into consideration. We don't want to have this too wet. And then we take this. And make that little andouille crust. Then, what we'll do, 375 degree oven. We'll take that 375 degree oven, and this is only going to take about 10-12 minutes, just until the shrimp are cooked. You don't want to overcook them. Now, I had one in here earlier, and what I did with this one is I actually took that crust and stuffed this particular one. It's really the option that you want to do. And you know something, if you're going to use scallops, you may want to consider, if you really got the big diver scallops, the big scallops, you might want to slice them. You may want to cut, if you don't have the little tiny little bays, you may want to cut them in half or maybe in a third and layer them out if you're using scallops instead of shrimp. Now, I have a lot of stuffed shrimp memories. I took my good old reliable cumin and mixed it with some sour cream. Very simple little flavorful sauce that you can use. And I'm just gonna put that like that. And then we're gonna scoop up a shrimp there. And then we're gonna scoop up another one there. And you wanna talk about a great little starter. Then we'll take this one and we'll fan that one out over there. What I like to do is I like to use in every possibility. And what I like to do is to take some of those extra crumbs, a little extra andouille. We'll spoon that one out. And then I think what we'll do is we'll take a little bit of that great essence that we have. And we'll just work some of the essence like that. And I got a little bit of chopped parsley. It's a very simple garnish. You know, if you cook these and it just so happens that maybe the crust got a little dry, maybe the oven was a little hot, you know, you don't have to be worried about just taking, you know, we use a lot of these sour cream and very simple flavored sauces. And, you know, you can do the same thing with oils, too. This is just a really simple little olive oil. And just great olive oil is delicious, too, that you can use, as you can see there. And you can use a little bit of chive cream like we did with our first one. And what a beautiful, simple little starter. And let me tell you something. When we come back, I got another new creation for you, so stay with me. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Everyone, well, look, you're probably wondering Sometimes. What do you do with all that yellowfin tuna you're catching down there in the Gulf? I'm going to show you a great little starter. Look at this beautiful, beautiful yellowfin tuna. It's sushi grade. It looks like sushi. I mean, you could just eat it just like that. But no. Wait till you see this. We're going to take a little bit of spice. Just a little bit. Okay? And this skillet is like super hot. We're going to put it right in there, in that hot skillet. And a little bit of oil. You see that? A little bit of oil, hot skillet. That's okay. While that's smoking away. Why is it smoking? Because I got all that spice on there. Let me show you what we're going to do. What we're going to do is we're going to take some beautiful fresh tomato. And we're going to take some chopped red onion. And a little bit of lemon juice. A little bit of lime juice. Fresh, of course. And now what we're going to do is we're going to... Hey, this is a big steak right here. We're going to flip it around. Get some color. Hey, let me show you something. You see how it's cooked? You can see the line almost like an indicator of where it's cooked. And we don't need to cook it that long because it could be just eaten raw like that. Now I'm going to come back. I'm going to add a little bit of red bell pepper and some jalapeno. We're going to kick it up a little bit with a little jalapeno. Now, I'm going to add a little bit of salt. And then what we're going to do... Now, you know what this is called? If we take this out right now, what we do is that would be called an escabeche, huh? Instead of a ceviche, an escabeche. Well, let me tell you what we're going to do. See, we got this beautiful... What we're going to do is this. We're going to come back, and we're going to take our tuna steak, as rare as it is, right? I'm going to take it right off the stove. And what I did here is I made some little croutons, okay? I made some little croutons right there. And let me show you what we're going to do. I'm going to take this in front of me. Check this. We're going to take and we're going to cut these little beautiful steaks, little slices of this. Okay? And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little crouton here and a little crouton there. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to fan out a little bit of this wonderful tuna. Hey, you see that? If it's kind of breaking apart, don't worry about it because I'm going to show you what we're going to do. Doesn't that look delicious? Now, see like this pot here? It's breaking apart. We just cut it in little pieces. And you can either just put it right there or what we're going to do is we take some of that and mix it in here like this. Woo-woo! Sort of the new wave tuna salad right here on the Television Food Network. Now, I'm going to mix some of that, right? And now what we're going to do is, first of all, we're going to give us a little cluster right there. Yeah. Get a little cluster right there. Then we're just going to drizzle a little of this over. You see? And then I took a little olive oil and a little cilantro. And I've got this beautiful little cilantro oil. You see that? And then what we're going to do is just add a little bit there and a little bit there and a little bit here and woo! Hey, a little bit there too. Can't forget him. And that is what I think is another great starter. to go with our starters. Maybe a little cilantro. Hey, we're having some fun here. Yes, indeed. The shrimp with andouille crust. Corn cakes with Louisiana caviar. And now this crazy thing, this 1994 TBFN tuna salad. What can I say? I hope you had a great time today. As much fun as I did. I'll see you tomorrow on The Essence of Emeril. See ya.